Hi, welcome to BaniTech channel. Here we are going to see why we use IDMT over current on feeder. For this we are going to consider one switchgear. Let us consider this is incomer. It connect with bus. And bus has many outgoing feeder. This all outgoing feeder is a load for incomer. Considering each taking 40 amps and it's the full load current for each feeder. So the incomer will take 320 amps as a load current, and also we are considering the incomer transformer full load current as 320 amps. Now we are going to see the fault condition over incomer feeder. For incomer alone we can consider three fault level. First, overload fault. Second, fault at load end. Third, fault at nearer to incomer. First we will see the fault at overload condition. Now the full load current in this feeder is 320 amps. According to the CT ratio, the secondary current is 0.64 amps. So I am going to keep overcurrent low stage pickup on 0.68 amps and the trip time is 5 seconds. Let we see this is correct or wrong. Here we have many motor and transformer. Normally they have a starting current is very high. This may lead to trip the incomer unnecessarily if we start more feeder suddenly. So in this case we have to start each feeder one by one slowly. Case 1, we consider all the feeder running in full load condition. Suddenly two feeder got overload, one transformer and one motor. Due to this, load current increase and reaches 380 amps. In this case, the incomer should give chance to this two outgoing feeder. They should trip first or their load should be normalized. But the tripping time for the incomer is very less. Due to that, the incomer feeder trip first. So the incomer trip due to this two feeder overload. This lead to power failure to all outgoing. Now we go for case 2. If all outgoing get overload, in this case the incomer get 540 amps primary and secondary 1.08 amps according to the CT ratio. So it is greater than the ISET. Due to this, the relay will start pickup and it will give trip by 5 seconds. In this case also it is not a fault but a current increase due to overload condition. Now we go for case 3. Here also all feeder get overload but the current is little higher than the previous case. But here also it will trip at 5 second only. Maybe this case we can have a 5 second to trip, but on previous two case the tripping on 5 second is unnecessarily because the incomer has to give chance to trip outgoing first, then only it has to take this own chance. In order to overcome this problem, for overload case, we have curve-based trip, that is IDMT. The full form of IDMT is inverse definite minimum time. This tripping characteristic will be like this. When the current increase and the tripping time will get reduced. And also in power system, we use various type of IDMT. On that commonly we have a 4 type, that is normally inverse or standard inverse. Second one is very inverse, third one is extremely inverse, fourth one is long time inverse. For all this curve generally we have one formula. T is equal to TMS into beta divided by IA by IS whole bracket alpha minus 1. Where IA is the actual current, IS is a set current, TMS is a time multiplier setting, alpha and beta is a constant which depend on curve type. These values are for normal inverse beta is 0.14 and alpha is 0.02. For very inverse beta is 13.5 and alpha is 1. For extremely inverse beta is 80 and alpha is 2. For long time inverse beta is 120 and alpha is 1. When we substitute this value over this formula, the formula we get for normal inverse is TMS into 0.14 divided by IA by IS whole bracket 0.02 minus 1. For very inverse, we get TMS into 13.5 divided by IA by IS whole bracket 1 minus 1. For extremely inverse, TMS into 80 divided by IA by IS whole bracket square minus 1. And the formula for long time inverse equal to TMS into 120 divided by IA by IS whole bracket power 1 minus 1. Now we are going to see the same overload with this curve settings. I am going to consider normal inverse curve. Same current setting and TMS is 0.8, and I am going to find the trip time now for this same overload condition. In case 1, we got 2 feeder overload. For normal inverse, this is the formula, and from this formula we have the all the value. For IA we can get from the CT secondary. Here we have 0.78, and if you substitute all this value over this formula, I got 50.29 second. So the incomer will wait for 50.29 second whether the load is coming back to normal or outgoing CB trip. If still load current is not reduced or this two feeder not get tripped, then to protect these two equipment, the incomer has to trip. Now we go for case 2. Here all the feeder are in overload, so the overload current is very high. Their actual current is 1.08 amps, and when you substitute over the formula, now the tripping time we get only 12.55 seconds. Now the incomer will wait for only 12.55 seconds since the load current increase. After that it will give the tripping command to the incomer breaker. In case 3, here also all outgoing feeder are having overload, but the actual current is quite higher than the previous case. We have the 1.24 amps in the secondary. When we substitute over the formula, we got trip time 9.26 seconds. It is clear that when the fault current increase and the tripping time is getting reduced in IDMT. How this IDMT is useful to feeder, we can see one example. Now we can see on case 1. We have seen two feeder has a overload. In this case, if the feeder get normal or if this two feeder get tripped by its own CB before 50.29 second, then the incomer still continue to serve and remain healthy feeder will get supply. Because since it have a high tripping time, this transformer and motor can become into normal or its breaker can be tripped due to this thermal. By making these three cases actual current, I have plotted this various curve. In all curve having the same TMS and same ISET current. By this we can able to see each curve having a different plot value and they having a own characteristics. Then how to select this curve, we can see that on separate section. I believe that you all will have a clear idea about IDMT. On next video we can see about a definite time and instantaneous overcurrent relay. We came to the end of the section. Be safe and see you all in next video. Take care and bye from Barney Tech Channel.